During the 50s and 60s, my friend Richard Parker was privileged to indulge his interest in steam trains, taking film of the last days of steam from platforms, vantage points, carriages, and on a few occasions from the footplate. This is one of those occasions when he travelled from Bournemouth to Waterloo aboard the 34047 Callington. On that occasion, he didn't have his tape recorder with him, so there is no sound. However, he did take a recorder with him when filming wherever he could. And on this film, we have matched the sound with the action wherever possible. Most of the film was taken on the Western region, and you will see passenger trains, goods trains, and station pilots going about their daily business. As diesel and electric gradually took over, very little attention was paid to the upkeep of the dwindling stock of steam engines. Indeed, they seemed to be condemned to work until they were no longer fit for purpose, as they say in today's vernacular. So why not sit back now and enjoy this amateur film of the last days of steam? Our train approaches Southampton. You can see the P&O liner Chusan getting ready for its next voyage to the Far East. In Southampton we take on water. Another steam train approaches us as we make our way towards London. London comes into view and our journey is very nearly over. West Country 462 Dartmoor will pass through Axminster on its way to Exeter. We are passing another West Country locomotive moving into the station. approach Axminster. Journey's End. We move to Banbury. Now we're at Wolvercote Sidings in 1964. We move back to Oxford. This scene is at Oxford Station. No names or numbers were recorded at the time. Here the Goodrich Castle is leaving Paddington Station. Stop along the way. Reggie Hanks, chairman of the BR Western Region Board, is seen talking to the senior locomotive inspector at Bicester Station. Now we're at Oxford, where a BR Standard 460 is seen arriving with the Down Bournemouth York Express. The up train is seen leaving for Bournemouth behind a Merchant Navy Class Pacific. We now join a BR Standard 460 on a journey from Oxford to Basingstoke. now seen approaching Reading West. As we pass through this station, young railway enthusiasts are seen showing interest in this particular working. We start part three with a bullied, unrebuilt Pacific, number 34086, about to leave for Exeter. Now we see the Up Worcester approaching Wolvercote Junction as the sun sets. He's hauled by an unidentified castle. Hall class, number 4920, Dumbleton Hall. Preparing and then leaving Oxford. Get a friendly wave from the driver and fireman as it departs with the Bournemouth York Express passing the old LNWR MPD. A rare shot of 6861 Crinant Grange at Oxford, followed by an unidentified castle. We see the Earl of Ducie passing the Yarnton signal box. We now travel from Reading West to Oxford, behind a Hall class locomotive. We're about to overtake a mixed traffic goods train. Another diesel passes, headed to Reading and Paddington. Shots around Basingstoke. More winter shots. we watch Earl of Ducie pass on a high-speed commemorative run to Paddington. Walton Well Bridge near Oxford. Wolvercote Junction, 1964. The last steam engine built by BR passes light engine from Yarnton. It's interesting to see the amount of freight carried by rail at that time. Now going from Oxford to Basingstoke. Thank you. join Penrith Castle 7023 from Kingham to Oxford with carriage views along the Cotswold line. Pass Finstock Halt. We also pass Yanton Junction for the Fairford line, where there was a large interchange goods yard. Arriving in Oxford. A bullied Pacific can be seen on the other line. Busy steam scenes at Oxford. Seven O 32 Denby Castle, one of the last series of castles with double chimney, leaving Oxford. We watch several trains passing over water troughs on the Cotswold line in 1964. shots from within the Oxford shed, the oldest then in existence, part of which was built by the Oxford, Worcester and Wolverhampton Railway in wood. You can hear the announcer from the nearby station. On this last Western Region steam hauled journey, on a bright January morning, Richard was fortunate enough to be in the front coach, behind Burton Agnes Hall. Pass yet another signal box along the way. Burton Agnes Hall draws into Banbury on this final steam hauled journey for the Western Region. change of crew. Reggie Hanks, the chairman, waves from the cab. Fortunately, Burton Agnes Hall was saved for preservation by the Great Western Society at Didcot. We're at King's Sutton Station as the 4:15 Paddington to Banbury makes a brief call. The last steam-hauled daily service from Paddington Station. Only 81 pence cheap day return in today's money. On a grey winter's afternoon, the downed Bournemouth leaves Oxford behind an unidentified bullied Pacific. Merchant Navy Class 35023, Holland Africa Line, leaving Oxford for Bournemouth. Start with scenes around Preston a year before the end of steam in summer 1967. London Midland Region Class 5, 460, number 44660. Seven-oh-oh-one-one BR Pacific leaves Preston with express goods. Here is the number 44872 LM Class 5 which we saw earlier. 44872 leaves with passengers. Oliver Cromwell is standing at Carnforth's shed. It was a pleasure to see such a clean engine, where all around was looking distinctly uncared for, awaiting withdrawal or scrap. We go back to the transition period. Here we see a diesel hauling the Bournemouth Belle. We moved to the Oxford and Cambridge line in 1964, by then operated by diesel. Richard is travelling in the driver's cab of this DMU. Hello. During the 60s, many unprofitable lines were closed by Dr. Peaching. This line was no exception, and as we arrive at Marsh, Gibbon and Poundham station, the driver puts his cap on as a mark of respect, and we see the closure notices. Narrow-gauged Vale of Rydal Railway was the only part of British Rail steam operated at this time. Used mainly by tourists, the train is preparing to leave the station. The fireman boards the engine. Locomotive number 9, Prince of Wales, is painted in BR blue of the period. The train makes its way down from Devil's Bridge to Aberystwyth, the terminus. The journey ends at Aberystwyth, where you will see a standard gauge station. We don't have any authentic sound for this clip, but it's such a fascinating engine that it would be a pity to leave it out. British-built steam engines were still to be seen overseas. Here we see a small, narrow-gauge engine being well looked after in Fiji in 1973. This particular engine is fitted for wood burning, as can be seen by the spark arrestor chimney. They were largely used amongst the plantations in whatever country they were employed. There are always boys to be seen when a steam engine is at work. Back in England, the changeover from steam to diesel didn't always go according to plan. Pannier tank passes on pickup goods from Njanton.